American Ninja Warrior is an obstacle course game show where people tackle ridiculously impossible challenges. Obviously, you have to be fit to make it through the course, but there's one aspect of fitness where the competitors usually fail. The weakest link, the reason that many of these athletes get eliminated, is grip strength. Of course, that's not the only reason. I mean, the whole point of the show is that completing it is nearly impossible. But a large portion of the obstacles are dependent on a strong grip. What's up, everyone? My name is Patrick. I was curious about some of the mechanics behind these challenges, specifically the hand and wrist. Like, what makes it such a weak link in the kinetic chain here? And what does the science say about how to make it potentially stronger? Before we get into the research, we need to know what structures we're working with. There are a lot of muscles involved in grip strength, and even those depend on which form of grip you're using, like all of these. Either way, the primary muscles responsible for grip strength are in your forearm, as you're painfully aware of if you've ever been rock climbing. On the anterior side, you have a bulk of muscles called the wrist flexor group, since they flex your hand, and on the backside, your wrist extensors. They both have origins close to the elbow joint at the medial and lateral epicondyles, respectively, both of which you can feel pretty easily. They thin out into long, slender tendons and cross the wrist where they move the hand. Unfortunately, those names are a little misleading because within that muscle mass are muscles that exclusively flex or extend the wrist and some that cross the wrist to curl your fingers, resulting in the gripping motion. And if you're hanging on with just your fingertips, you use even fewer, even tinier muscles. Again, climbers know this very well. What's counterintuitive, though, is which forearm muscles are the most important. It totally makes sense to think that your wrist flexors would be the best area to focus on, what with the way they curl your wrist downward and everything, but it's actually your wrist extensors that make the biggest difference. This is going to come up later on, but the wrist extensors act synergistically with the wrist flexors. EMG recordings show that as the force from your wrist flexors increases, so does the force from extensors. That's what makes grip strength so unique. It's less brute force like a bicep curl and more of a balancing act. So yeah, wrist and finger flexion is how you wrap your hand around a bar, but wrist extension is how you hold on tight. What makes Ninja Warrior even more interesting is how your grip has to change along with a changing body position. And decades of experiments show us that the position of other body parts impacts grip strength. We'll start with the easiest to understand, hand spread. Bigger objects are harder to grip. Like, compare a basketball, which I just always have under my desk at all times, to this vase. I can't even wrap my hand around half of either, but at least I can hold on to the vase. I can't do the basketball. Part of that is because, yeah, bigger hands means you can cover greater surface area of the ball, but it also impacts something called the length tension curve. There's a just right length that each muscle provides the strongest contraction. If your hand is stretched out over a big object, it won't grip as strongly as it would when the muscle is in a shorter position. Many of the ninja obstacles are so challenging because you're grabbing an oversized hold or bar. And a study from 2007 shows that when you increase the diameter of the bar, you decrease your ability to do the lift itself. Take the salmon ladder, for example, which uses a larger diameter bar. Even though the large muscles on your back and shoulders haven't gotten weaker, your ability to do the move is worsened by the weaker grip point. But it's not just your hand. Literally every joint up the kinetic chain can tweak your grip strength. Unfortunately, it seems like every review I read had conflicting results. One of the only consistent aspects was that grip strength was greater when you're standing up compared to lying down. And of course, these studies are done in super calm situations with a standard hand ergometer, so a little different than the crowds and cameras from Ninja Warrior. One aspect that deserves a little bit of a deeper dive in this video is wrist position. Greatest grip strength comes from about 20 to 45 degrees of wrist extension with ever so slight ulnar deviation. The hand moves toward the pinky. You can try this at home. If you move your wrist into flexion, you won't be able to make a fist, but extend your wrist as much as you can and you'll still be able to clench shut. Basically, you can drastically weaken grip strength with just a few mechanical tweaks. And with the chaos around the ninja course, you can forgive the athletes for not worrying about ergonomics. So if you can't necessarily optimize for grip strength during the competition, your next best option will be to train and strengthen your grip. But even that's hard to do. Now, most of the research in this field is conducted on elderly folks because a weak grip is a good predictor of mortality. So physical therapists will have their patients work on exercises like what you might have seen in Doctor Strange. Researchers have compared these functional exercises against targeted weightlifting of the forearm muscles and found that, again, they got pretty comparable results as long as the older adults did something. But for these studies, lots of researchers admit that they really don't know what mechanism is responsible for improvements difference in grip strength. It could be neural adaptations, increased dexterity, but it's still a mystery. Now, these rehab exercises are gonna be way too easy for the younger athletic type. So coaches naturally have looked into the best weightlifting routine. One study published in 2004 in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research took a high school baseball team and put them into two groups of about 20 kids each. Both got a traditional preseason weightlifting program, but half of them got additional forearm exercises. It was a pretty challenging extra credit workout. Wrist curls, extensions, ulnar and radial deviation, and plate grips. Unfortunately, after those 12 weeks of training, the only thing group 2 did was get stronger at those particular lifts. But when it came to actual grip strength, both groups improved by the same amount. 3 months of dedicated forearm exercises made no difference in grip strength compared to the group that did deadlifts and bicep curls, but no forearm work. Both groups upped their grip strength by about 5%, so it made a difference as if they did no exercise, but there was no difference between the groups. It seems like the older adults, as long as they did something, they improved their grip strength. But like I said earlier, grip strength is more about balance and less about bulk. Remember the synergistic effect of the wrist extensors? Some studies in young people show that exclusively strengthening the wrist extensors can improve grip strength. One study published in the European Journal of Applied Physiology in 2011 looked into training the wrist extensors isometrically, that is, without the wrist moving. The team measured their 13 subjects' grip strength with a dynamometer before and after, but they also did an EMG. They measured the electrical activity of the motor neurons controlling certain muscles. Remember how there are over 30 muscles involved in grip? EMG data can give us an idea as to which muscles were the most active that led to that reading on the dynamometer. So the group took their initial measurements, then for 8 weeks they had subjects do 30 reps of this exercise for 5 days a week. This was plenty of time to see both neural adaptations and some hypertrophy. At the end of the trial, the subjects saw less dominance in their wrist flexors and more from their extensors and significantly increased gripping force. The researchers think that the rebalancing of forces, as well as the additional muscle mass, was responsible for the hashtag gains. As far as documented science goes, there's still no clear winner as to the best way to improve grip strength. Keep in mind that a lot of the research on this topic out there is inconsistent, both in the way that they do their methodology in testing and in their small sample sizes. So if you're planning your strategy for grip strength domination, it might be worth trying out a few routines and seeing what works best for you. Thank you so much for watching this video. I was actually inspired to make this one after watching some of the challenge videos on Mike Boyd's channel. If you want to check him out, you can see them in the description. Otherwise, you can check out some more of my videos here or hit subscribe to support the channel. Have fun, be good. Thanks for watching.